Hey folks, this is Sean Losis here, and today I'm going to show you my methods of overcoming root rot when growing the American apple seedlings in the tropics, i.e. Jamaica. Typically, root rot is caused by a fungus or a bacteria. Here are some prime examples of root rot. You notice that the soil is still wet, but the seedlings are struggling to survive due to overwatering. One of my first methods I started to use to avoid root rot is using sand. In my opinion, most persons don't know it, but sand is one of the best soils used to grow American apple seedlings. Lucky for me, I'm fortunate enough to live close by the Ryokobi River, where there's a natural abundant supply of sand. If you observe closely, you realize that I'm actually using seedling trays instead of the typical one container method. With seedling trays, I'm able to grow more seedlings while using less soil. So now after 2 weeks, these are the results. Hey, if you made it this far in the video, please like, share and subscribe. It really helps a lot with the algorithm. Thanks. Another contributing factor to reducing root rot is having an adequate breeding space. As you can see, there's a natural flow up here where I actually placed my seedling trays. One minor issue when using sand is that it does not retain moisture for very long. However, the thing I like about using sand is that it easily absorbs the water without leaving any muddy residue. Another prevention method is removing aphids, otherwise called whiteflies. These small insects are typically found on the leaves, and they usually suck the essential minerals needed by the plant to fight off any fungal and bacterial diseases. By using a mist spray, you can remove all aphids without damaging the plant. By the way, it's highly recommended that you check for aphids daily, as it can easily multiply and go undetected and cause major damage. Now it's been a few weeks and these are the results. As you can see, all seedlings are doing very well, nice and healthy. Very firm and very strong. From time to time, I usually apply a mist spray just to cool them down. Besides seedlings, root rot can also occur in young saplings. For example, this young apple tree is suffering from a condition called crown rot, typically caused by a fungal infection in the soil and made worse by overwatering. To prevent this from happening, I started to use mycorrhizal fungi, a beneficial fungi that colonizes the plant roots, providing essential minerals and nutrients for the plant in exchange for sugar from the plant roots. Here's an example of me applying mycorrhizal fungi to few of my saplings before transplanting them. If you observe closely, you can see that I'm evenly distributing the mycorrhizal fungi around the roots. Just like before, for this transplant, I'll be using the same sand. Besides the roots, I typically apply a little bit of mycorrhizal fungi to the soil before transplanting. Hey, if you made it this far in the video and found the information useful, please hit the like button. It really helps a lot with algorithms. Thanks. Another method you can use if you don't have sand is soil sterilization. This is usually done by cooking / steaming the soil for about 2 hours. This ensures that all soil-borne diseases are destroyed, such as fungi, pathogens, and bacteria. Here are some of my results when using these methods to prevent root rot, including the American apple seedlings in Jamaica.
Hey, if you made it this far in the video, please like, share, and subscribe. It really helps a lot with the algorithms. Respect.